Hello and welcome to my F1 22 driver career mode. Here today for part 37 for the Canadian Grand Prix and round 5 for season 3 of the career mode. We come into this race off of the Monaco Grand Prix where we had a very good result, not only me personally but as a team as well. But we come into this weekend with rain expected, not only in qualifying as you can see here for wet conditions but also for the race as well. But before I get to the race, here is qualifying, the qualifying report, and this was very, very tricky conditions as we come into the final chicane now, over it, nearly dropping the back end, and now we go up to the line, we cross it, and we go P6, straight down to P7 now, someone else went faster behind. On the same set of tyres we went again, into the final corner, go a little bit over the curb, give the wall a little kiss, and now come up to the line, cross it, and that's P2.
Yes, mate, that's P2.
Just 0.005 of a second off of Charles Leclerc, and towards the end of the session, it's time for the inters. The track did dry up a little bit, so we found a lot of time with purple in the first sector, but we've only got a personal best in the middle sector. We go a little bit wide going into the hairpin, nearly dropped the back end on the exit, so that's lost us a little bit of time. But we're going to come up the straight now into the final chicane. Pink Gasly sets the fastest lap. We're into P2, now P3, everyone's going quicker, but can we get pole position? Back to back pole positions? No, we can't. Here is the grid.
Let's run you through the driver grid order for today's exciting race. Charles Leclerc lines up on pole position. A very happy Carlos Sainz will start second. Considering the rest of the grid we have, Norris, Brown, Max Verstappen, and Fernando Alonso. Russell, Perez, Hamilton, and Yuki Tsunoda. Magnussen, Albon, Oscar Piastri, and Gasly. Joe, Ocon, Mick Schumacher, and Lance Stroll. Schwartzman, and Nicholas Latifi. Now, it's almost time for lights out, so let's go down to the track.
So, the rain is coming, you can see there on the weather indicator. So, my thinking was to start on the softs and hope the rain came before the soft tyres ran out of grip. We're starting it behind Lando. It's another front wheel lockout for Ferrari, and it is also time for the Canadian Grand Prix. It's lights out and away we go, and for once we get a good start. We look down the inside of Lando though, we had to get the corner to try and avoid him. They're all on the mediums, so they will definitely be able to get to the rain if it does come early on in the Grand Prix. But we're on the back now of our teammate. We couldn't get through the first couple of corners, we couldn't get him. But it's the Ferrari 1-2 from Sainz. He's managed to keep the lead. He's been in great form. We're in every race apart from the one last time out in Monaco when he retired. So he's looking to bounce back this weekend onto lap 2. And now we have tried to set up a lovely move into turn 1 on Lando. And we have going through the chicane. We're gaining a lot of time. We're now on the back of him. And we are going to try and go to the outside. We swap in the dummy. And now go back round the outside. Lando fends it off. So we're going to do the same thing again. Swapping another dummy down the inside. And we get Lando. He made that very difficult for us, but we get him in the end. Now it's time to hunt after the two Ferraris. Lando did get us back as the rain did come on lap 7. And the tyres were starting to go off a little bit. We were just skating around onto lap 8 now, and the rain is definitely here, and it is definitely time as Lando went down the inside of the hairpin, and now it is a drag race to the pits. One of us may lose a lot of time, so it's made sure that we beat Lando into the pits just as it's time for the intermediate tyres. We're going to completely screw Lando's race, unfortunately. but it's good that we managed to do it. And as we come in then, Lando's behind us. And we can get away well, Lando. Hopefully he doesn't lose too much time as Sainz has come in. But Charles Leclerc on those tyres has stayed out. So Ferrari for once doing something clever and look like us, McLaren. So we are going to come out in some clean air. Those ahead of us though, Verstappen, have still yet to box. Apart from Sainz, I think he has boxed. As we are going wheel to wheel with the Dutchman, we get the job done. Here is Charles Leclerc now coming out of the pits. Have we done enough to potentially beat out Charles? We did get held up quite a bit by Max through the first couple of corners that I cut out. It wasn't really relevant, but we've come out and we're much closer to Charles Leclerc as we were before the rain decided to come down. As we skip on, and Albon has been caught out by the conditions. He's been hit by the Aston Martin. He's blocked Max Verstappen, and now everyone's just queuing behind him. He's ghosted, and this has brought out the first safety car of the day. The safety car is out, and now these two turned around. It's actually given Piastri and Gasly a penalty as well, as they struggle to get away. This is a replay of what happened at into turn one. Albon just lit up the rear tyres and it spun him round, and Max just sat there. I don't know why he hasn't tried to at least get through. Here what it looked like from Max. There was even a gap, he could have gone over the kerb, but he decided not to. And it was Sir Lancelot who hit the back of Albon. He could have gone round, but apparently that Williams is too nice and had to be hit. But this is the safety car now, as everyone trundles through. That gap, we were just kind of sticking with Charles there. We couldn't quite get close enough to have a go. But now, hopefully, we can. As we go into the first couple of corners, we're going to send it on Charles Leclerc to the inside, and we get him, and we're going to take P2. And now can we get Carlos Sainz around the outside? Tried Fernando Alonso on Charles Leclerc going through turn two. It looks like Leclerc may have just kept him behind, and yes he has. We nearly drop it on the exit of the second chicane. Sainz is away, but for some reason the game has given us no tyre temperature as we let the game take over for us. We had no grip, our tyres were stone cold, and that has really hurt us. And we did lose out to Leclerc. We couldn't really get back on him, as Sainz now pits because the track conditions have got even worse, and it's time for the full wet tyres. Sainz is there, we come into the pits. Lando's followed us again, and the race leader Carlos Sainz has been held up by us, by Lando. Some people may think that there are some dodgy tactics there by McLaren to try and get us ahead. We are now ahead of Sainz. Sainz is now going to go plunging down the order as everyone comes out of the pits to make this up. You can see on the timing tower just where Sainz is. Has now come in down the back straight. We've also lost a lot of time, so we need to get our way back through, just like we did in Miami. We tried to go down the inside of George and he wasn't having it, but now we're going to set him up to have a go into turn one. Can we do it? We're going to pull to the inside, we're going to send it late down the inside of George Russell. Job done, and we're going to come out side by side, the other Mercedes of Lewis Hamilton. We get both of them, them two are battling, we'll leave them to it. Next up is the AlphaTauri of Esteban Ocon. We send it to the inside at the hairpin. We've got some great pace on these full wet tyres. It's Sergio Perez now, from absolutely nowhere. I think he was staying around 7th, 8th place. Currently leads Canadian Grand Prix from absolutely nowhere. It's been some great strategy played by Red Bull. He's got Leclerc all over the back of him, and I think we may have an inside chance of a podium and maybe even a win here, as there's another safety car because the conditions have got too bad to race in. And you can see, you can't even see the cars as they go down the pit straight. But this has also brought us back into play if this race does get underway again, because the conditions are very, very poor. Similar to 2011 when Jenson Button won that race. But the safety car did come back in, and once again we had stone cold tyres, as you'll be able to see here. They're stone cold, and in these conditions they're not helpful at all. But we are going to send it to the inside of Fernando Alonso, but we had to give the place back, lift off. But then we tried to get the exit, but these tyres are still cold, so we are skating around the first couple of corners into the second chicane. And now, can we have a go on Alonso? This is further round, but Alonso's made a mistake. Alonso's locked up, and we've gone thank you very much and through past our former teammate. And next up is Tsunoda, and with 10 laps to go, could we possibly win this Grand Prix in an excellent comeback drive? Possibly. Carlos Sainz, you can see where he is. We've completely screwed over his race. He's down in 13th place. He wanted to get a good result after Monaco and his DNF. I mean, come on now, there's 2 laps to go. It's looking unlikely. There's still a chance though. Through the kink, and Charles Leclerc has dropped it. He cracked under the pressure that we were putting him under, and Charles Leclerc has spun here in Canada in the final chicane, at the second to last chicane, and now he's coming under pressure from the Alpine of Yuki Tsunoda, but he just about fends him off. But Tsunoda, he's not giving up. They're side by side going up the back straight. Can Tsunoda get through? Here we are. Ferrari gonna regret that spin, and Leclerc's gonna regret that spin, but he gets the exit to the outside, and that is just gonna keep him ahead of the Alpines after that bag mistake. You can see it here. He just goes, similar to Albon, just goes into the corner, lights up the rear tyres, and that has made our day very, very easy. And now we have 2 laps to try and overtake Sergio Perez. But this is Carlos Sainz, and he's slowing down. Carlos Sainz is slowing down. That's not spray, that is smoke. That Ferrari engine has popped again, 2 races in a row. It's all going wrong for Carlos Sainz. He was unbeatable in the first 3 races. Now he can't finish the races. Monaco DNF. Canada DNF, but it's a 1-lap shootout for the lead of the Grand Prix and the win. We get the job done on Sergio Perez on the final lap. He's led since the wet tyres, and we have got through. We were hunting. Charles Leclerc's spin has helped us out there, but it's a 1-lap shootout for the race win. It's just like it was in 2011, a 1-lap shootout, and it's a Red Bull and a McLaren, but this time it's me and Sergio Perez. And once again it was the Red Bull going into the lead on the final lap. Perez tries to go to the inside. We are all over trying to keep him behind. Perez is going to go to the inside again, and he backs out of it, but we go a bit wide. We go very wide. Perez is trying to get up the inside on the exit, but we get the better exit. Now there's one more chance for Sergio Perez to have a go and retake the lead at the end that we took from him on the start of the lap. He goes to the outside. We defend the inside line out of the final corner. We're gonna win one of the most greatest races of all time.
That's the race win. That is the race win. You've been amazing today, mate. You deserve that. Well done. A beautiful performance from McLaren today. Natalie Pinkham, how do you think they were able to set themselves apart today?
Rain always has the potential to liven up a race and mix up the order, and they've taken full advantage of that to claim the victory today. It's a bit of a lottery when the conditions are like this, but they've managed to stay on the circuit and come out on top.
Our drivers are making their way out for the podium celebrations, and it's going to be McLaren picking up the winner's trophy. Congratulations to the entire team for that fantastic performance.
What a race, what a Canadian Grand Prix, on the level, possibly, of 2011. Just like that race was, it was decided on the final lap, because that time it was between Button and Vettel. This time it's between me and Perez, and we came out on top in one of the best comeback drives I think I've ever done. I think that tops any race we've had in this career mode so far, by far the best one. And it all went to pot for Ferrari. It was looking so good in the early stages. They were both 1-2, but then Sainz's engine went pop for the second race in a row, and that's really dented his lead in the championship as well. And then Leclerc, on for a good P2, spins as well, and that result means we're level on points, but we are top of the drivers' championship. Sainz has slipped down to third after he was looking unbeatable after the first three races. Back-to-back DNFs in a 10-race season could be very costly, and once again, Ferrari are letting something slip, but Leclerc is still in the fight. We are still in the fight. So is just about Lando. He's only 1 point behind Sainz, but compared to the lead he had going into Monaco last time out, very extortionate. We have jumped Red Bull, who, even with their second place, has jumped up to fourth, jumping Mercedes. Alpine's still third. We are still second in the Constructors' Championship. It's only Alfa Romeo, who are still yet to score this season. What an incredible race after the halfway point of the 2024 Formula One season. The championship is hotting up, and I think we've just witnessed one of the greatest races of all time. Coming back through the field, we may have completely screwed Lando's race and Carlos Sainz's. There's definitely some questionable and some conspiracy theories out there right now, but I hope you enjoyed this video, and I'll see you in the next one, where we head to Silverstone for the British Grand Prix.